Loretta Young.
Hello, my name is Christopher Lewis, and I'd like to welcome you to the golden age of television, the 1950s. It was a very special time indeed, a time of challenge and freedom and excitement. Television was in its infancy. The airwaves were filled with people like Milton Berle and Ed Sullivan, Hopalong Cassidy, and Loretta Young. For 9 years during the 50s, my mother hosted a weekly anthology series on NBC. It would become one of the most popular shows on television. It earned my mom 3 Emmy Awards and established her as one of the most respected and best-dressed women in America. Now, we're going to travel back to 1953 in just one moment, but first, how did Loretta Young become one of the most popular personalities on television? Well, hers is one of those fairy tale Hollywood stories. My mother's story begins in Salt Lake City, Utah in 1913, when she was born the 3rd of 4 children to Gladys and John Earl Young. By the time Mom was 4, her parents were separated, and Grandma brought her, her brother, and sisters to Los Angeles, where Grandma had a brother who was an assistant director in the movies. It wasn't long before the young children were appearing in movies themselves. Here they traveled all the way to Catalina Island to appear with Jack Mulhall and Louise Lovely in Sirens of the Sea. This was my mother's very first film role. She played a sea nymph. She has often told me that from the very first time she stepped in front of a camera, she knew she wanted to be a movie star. It didn't take her long to get her wish. For a remarkable 20 years during Hollywood's golden age of the 1930s and 40s, she made almost 100 films and played opposite the biggest leading men in the business. She's best remembered for her films Call of the Wild, The Crusades, and Now Tomorrow, Suez, The Bishop's Wife, and Come to the Stable. But it wasn't until 1947 that she was given the greatest honor in Hollywood, the coveted Academy Award. Frederick March presented it to her for her performance as a Swedish farm girl in the classic The Farmer's Daughter.
That's my heart. You know, up until now, presentations of the Academy Awards has been a purely spectator sport for me. However, tonight I dressed for the stage just in case.
As the 1940s came to a close and the second half of the century dawned, my mother had accomplished more than she had ever dreamed of back when she first stepped before the movie camera. And it was with my father, Tom Lewis, that she would now turn to television. Against the advice of her agents and studio executives, Mom and Dad financed and produced the first episode of a new dramatic anthology series that they called Letter to Loretta. It would star Loretta Young, who would introduce each week's program by answering a viewer's letter. The pilot was sold to the very first company to see it, Procter & Gamble. And in September of 1953, the first Loretta Young Show premiered on Sunday night at 10 p.m. For the very first time, a popular motion picture star was now appearing on television. From September of 1953 until June of 1961, Mom appeared in 163 of the 256 Loretta Young Show episodes that she produced for NBC. In 1962, the new Loretta Young Show appeared for one season on CBS before she retired from films for the next 23 years. However, NBC lured her out of retirement in the late 1980s to appear in 2 more television movies, Christmas Eve, released during the holiday season of 1986, and Lady in a Corner 3 years later. In the 1990s, Mom moved to Palm Springs, California, where, at the age of 80, she married a longtime friend and her Academy Award-winning dress designer, Jean-Louis.
Mom passed away on August the 12th, 2000, at the age of 87.